In the aftermath of a disturbance, whether a natural disturbance or human-caused disturbance, one thing that happens is that the trees that are still standing have more light, more room to grow, and so they're able to grow more quickly. This is a 90-year-old tree, so this area is probably a pasture around the time of the Great Depression, regenerated into the single generation of white pine. What you can tell by looking at the stump is not just the age of the tree, which you can tell by counting these growth rings, but you can also tell how good of a year each year was by how thick it is. So on a year where the tree had more room to grow, maybe had more light and water and other things like that, the growth rings will be really thick. And in a year where maybe there was a drought or if the pine tree was crowded, didn't have enough room to grow, the growth rings will be thinner. Now, what you can tell by looking at that stump is that when the pine tree started until about here, which is about year 50, the pine tree was growing really, really well. You can tell that because the growth rings are all pretty thick. What probably happened is that as this generation of pine trees was establishing in this old pasture, for the first 50 years of their life, they had plenty of room to grow. And then suddenly it got big enough that their canopies started to crowd together and they didn't have the same access to light or resources. They had to deal with the stressors of competing with their neighbors. So they weren't able to put on as much growth. That trend of slower growth continued until about here, which is about 40 years ago. 40 years ago is an interesting time in the history of this forest because we know that 40 years ago, around 1980, was the last time that this forest was managed. Now, at 40 years ago, the growth rings suddenly start getting really big. What happened is that around 1980, when some of these trees are cut, the trees that were left behind had way more room to grow, and so they could suddenly start putting on a lot of growth again. Now, that rapid growth continued until about 15 years ago, which is probably when the canopies of these trees closed against one another, and suddenly they were competing with their neighbors again. Now we've come back in here again. We've retained a lot of those big white pine trees and given them more room to grow so they'll be able to increase their growth and get even bigger. Now you might be saying, why do we need to thin our forest? The strongest trees will win, the weaker ones will die, and that thinning will happen naturally over time. One of the reasons why I think it's so important to proactively thin our forest is number one, because a lot of our forests have this legacy of poor land management where people have been cutting the biggest, healthiest trees and leaving the least healthy ones behind for a long time. And now for a forest to be healthy, we want to encourage the healthiest trees proactively. And number two, because we're at this unprecedented moment in time where our trees are under a tremendous amount of stress. They're under stress, not just from the normal stresses of competing against their neighbors, but they're also under the stresses of climate change, right? So they're experiencing droughts, weather events of increased severity, experiencing changes in when and how the different seasons come.
By giving trees more room to grow, we can help them respond to all of these novel threats and stressors and encourage a healthier forest moving into the future. It's a simple idea. You know, we've created a situation where it is hard for trees and forests to be healthy. We are undoubtedly the biggest threat to ecosystems, to biodiversity, to ecology, and we're also probably their only hope for a better future.
I don't think that every forest or every tree needs to be managed, but I do believe that we can have a positive role in helping our forests be healthy.